see how ranks.
Jabber entrance, I love it.
I also love that SmackDown entrance when we're on Raw.
Yeah.
What's wrong with him? Oh my god, Randy Orton's just a call in this.
Look how shit his tattoos
are. Oh. It's just a generic fucking gear, man. I love it.
Remember when his arm...
You could, yeah, there we go.
Remember you could see his arms?
Yes. Oh, man.
I'm nearly sure I used to be in love with him. And then, like, he disappeared. It was like a cover of Raw, where it was Evolution, and they had all the Ferraris behind them.
Mm.
Oh. Oh, yeah.
Did it make you feel things?
It made me feel things about a car that I never knew I had.
I remember watching, like, as I was watching wrestling when I was growing up, and obviously I was a fan of Bradshaw, but I remember him disappearing on Raw. Like, he just disappeared. Fell in obscurity. Then, fucking randomly, this blonde guy turns up on fucking SmackDown.
I remember that as well.
I was like, who the fuck is this?
And, like, again, like, because there's not actually no continuity between the two. It's like one character died and the other one just took his place.
Yeah.
Oh, my goodness. It's Planet Stasiak. Where should we go? Captain!
There was no transition to it. It was literally just suddenly he's blonde hair and he's fucking on SmackDown.
God, even Captain's his...
Long. Captain! Long. Starship 9258359.
I entered the Enterprise is talking to get into the Monday Night Raw Arena.
You think that was the gimmick?
Mr. Sulu!
I think so. I think that was actually
If Sean Stasiak did a Captain Kirk impression, that man would be over overnight. Could you imagine that?
Especially
if he just
now.
Dressed up in the uniform.
Especially now.
Yes. Can you imagine? All of his matches are like fake the Gorn fight. Just there going like...
Is he still alive?
Is it...
He's like a weird...
He's acting.
What are you doing, Mr. Simpson?
He actually has like a legitimate job.
He's a chiropractor, yeah.
Yeah.
What? Oh my god.
An actual successful one.
Yeah, he's a brilliant chiropractor apparently. One of the best.
Okay.
Which is mental to think of that.
But again... In this universe, we could have made him Captain Kirk. He could have had a hairpiece on. And he could have been doing just like fake, like really shit foot punches. And the double axe handle. Foxy, just the...
Oh, that would have been hilarious. Someone has to do that now when we come back to wrestling.
Hi, Angel. If you're listening, watch a bit of the original Star Trek and get back to us. We can work something out.
Yeah. Oh man.
Alright, I'm
not just
looking
at
that. I spelt his
the idea of it.
I spelt his name wrong and it brought up a load of XXX rated sites.
Brilliant.
I'm sure it did.
That's I'm sure you already.
So do you know what? I'm just gonna take your word for it, he's a chiropractor.
I'm not delving into this.
Either way,
I was not in incognito mode either,
either
so
way. Either way, he's snapping and cracking.
Do you remember when me, you and Lorraine were chatting? And I was like, I need to find a picture of what this person was asking for. And I went onto incognito mode and it was like, the dog with the boobs and the catsuit came up.
Yeah.
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 That's why.
Holy shit, look at that. Top rope arm drag from Randy Orton on Mark Henry. Oh, this is a gimmick. Let's fucking commentate over this. Right, who are we going for here? We obviously want Orton to win, but who should he target first? Ooh, nice shoulder breaker there from Bradshaw.
Okay, well, Goldust. I thought they were. It's just not a tag team, no?
Apparently.
No, it's clearly not, because Bradshaw's attacking Orton.
Well, it actually looks like it's an elimination. It's not actually over the top rope. Pinfall or submission. Which makes this a massive clusterfuck.
Yeah, car crash.
Okay, Sean Stasiak's gone for roll up.
Wouldn't be messed up if Stasiak won.
That would be beautiful. I'm not going to lie, I would pop for that.
Randy, what are you doing?
Schoolboy for Goldust. Oh, Captain Stasiak kicks out. And Stasiak replies with a dropkick. Randy Orton's working down the leg of Bradshaw, as we all know is his weakness. Tajiri, another kick out there.
That's one match I've never done. I've never done
a multi-man elimination
where it's like
painful.
Going on at once.
Yeah.
To be fair, that's
if you wanted to,
and I don't mean this to sound disrespectful, but that would be a lot to ask. I think. Of
yeah.
You.
Well, unless it was
I'd
coordinated.
Think brilliant.
Yeah.
Like, it'd be brilliant for
depending on who it is.
Yes.
You could have so much fun with that.
You could, but I'm also thinking if this was pre certain days, you would also have an awful lot of arseholes in that ring.
Oh yeah.
like.
No, what they do is they just try and just like take a piss out of you. They've done like roll ups like 10 minutes just to knock you out. Like.
Oh, that's happened.
They totally pull ribs on
you. That's happened before.
Yeah. But yeah, I know, with two people though. Imagine if it was at six. And now Foxy retracts his statement saying it was going to be fun.
I actually like the idea of it.
I retract mine. I actually want this to happen and I just want Foxy to get fucked over. just so I can be like, you wanted this.
I get fucked over enough in wrestling, so like, fuck it.
And that makes it better. It's not even just by the wrestlers. It's by all of us.
Yes. Literally the pull of all of our jokes.
All you fans.
You marks. You fucking marks.
I'm not even going to say any more.
No.
There you go.
Speak through me, Foxy.
You can say can hurt us any more than we hurt ourselves.
Yes.
Okay.
Oh, hang on. Orton's going for a pin.
Over Goldust.
Oh. Nearly.
Who's going out first?
Oh, hang on.
Henry's going for it. Goldust going again.
Look at that slide in.
Rope.
He kicked out.
Nah, monkey man.
Yeah.
Can't.
Fuck off.
There's no way you can.
Screw you! Oh, now all of a sudden you want to follow the rules, Foxy.
You've never done that before.
Oh, that was a nice
look at
setup.
That sick moonsault.
That was a nice setup.
Mmm. Orton's really working over Goldust here, I have to say.
And Tajiri took out Foxy.
Oh,
you fucking prick, Tajiri! You hate you! I hate you! You dick! Fuck you, Tajiri! Okay, Orton, let go of him now.
Look at that.
That just looks like you're eating his ass. Okay, that was just too much.
Yeah, Vondi, you're only making Goldust more powerful this way.
Come on, Randy. Earl, Foxy, get it together.
Come on, Foxy,
get it together. Randy, what the hell are you doing? Randy.
Okay, so.
Randy, are you fucking kidding me? You could have had a pin there again.
Fuck. Zayzak just got yeeted. Oh, hello. Tad just going for it. Buzzsaw kick to Bradshaw.
There you go. 1, 2.
Bradshaw's out.
For a minute there, I thought fucking Mark Henry was about to like stop the pin.
Stasiak's out.
Okay.
Lads, this is still Orton's.
No, it's not.
It's in play, lads. It's in play.
Right, Randy. Come on, Randy.
Just work over goal.
Come on, Randy. Randy.
If it's not gonna be Orton, I'm thinking it's either Tajiri or Mark Henry.
It has to be Mark Henry.
Ooh.
Oh, that's Tajiri out.
2. Boom.
Nice.
Right.
Okay.
Randy,
down to the
you
last
have
three.
A chance here. Okay. Yeah. Let Mark do his thing.
Oh shit.
Let Mark do his thing. Don't get involved. Let Mark do his thing.
Yes.
And you have a fin. What are you doing?
What is he doing?
What are you doing?
He's not going for the finisher.
What are you doing?
He's going for Schoolboy. Oh, Mark Henry.
Randy,
you
have a finisher. Why are you
fire my soul?
Oh,
use your finish.
That's inexperience. That's all pure inexperience from Randy's part.
What a rookie.
Good God, why did we not pick Randy Orton to play?
We should have picked Randy Orton.
Because the Diamond Cutter's in this. We could have given him the RKO early. Oh, Goldust is going for it. Oh, he set up. It was an assist.
Boom.
Overdrive. No, don't do it. No, you burned his finisher.
Oh, you motherfuckers.
It was all Goldust's plan. Look. Yeah, all part of the plan. Look at this. It's captivating
stuff, lads. That was a bitch slap that hit two people.
Yes.
Is he Trent 7?
Hey. Leave Trent alone.
That's a compliment.
I know, but don't bring him up.
Yeah. He's unredacted, but still.
I know, but still.
He's still questionable?
No, well.
He's just...
Quite. New evidence has come to light.
I better check those forms.
Oh, hang on. Oh, Goldust is waiting there, and Orton fucked it up. Orton is holding his own here, lads, I have to say. He really is.
Right, get away from Goldust, because Goldust...
You say that now.
But to be fair now, Goldust was trying to set up for the Shadow Dreams there, and it didn't work. Now, look...
Mark Henry
should. Against sexual chocolate as well. You've just nullified his one weapon.
I find it funny that like...
Come on,
Randy! I find it fun that like the video games, they don't pull punches when it comes to like the moves.
No.
Like a low blow is a fucking low blow.
It's an actual kick
to
the balls, yeah. Okay.
Randy. Come on, Randy. It's fucking Goldust. Goldust.
Goldust. Title for the video. In the twilight of his career, he's Goldust.
Goldust.
That's why he should be called an AEW now. Bastards, just fucking waste an opportunity. Fucking AEW.
Oh, come on.
I know, is that... That's
Foxy!
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 Come on, Foxy!
Honestly, Foxy, man, you're full of shit, man.
Oh, I can't do it.
No surprises.
Come on, Randy.
Nice suplex. Come on, Randy.
Oh, yeah.
Small package.
Two.
Why is this a slow count?
Yes. Randy fucking Orton has arrived.
I've never been excited for a Randy Orton match before. Jesus Christ, I was excited
that was
for that.
That was impressive. Look at that. Yes.
I can't believe I did it.
Amy, do the thumbnail. It's important. Yes.
I hope they get
totally
my
worth
scale.
It.
I hope my scale is in it as well, just like this.
Your fucking Pete Dunne face, like, with the hair over the
Miz girl.
We still have we actually have video evidence of me being a Miz girl, so let's like,
yeah,
not
in fairness.
Go there.
Okay, Foxy, you're back in control. We have now disrupted the timeline enough. Randy Orton is now over.
Although to be fair, he was always over in our hearts.
Yes. Nothing you can say.
Back in like 2000. Between like 2000 and like 2006.
Yeah.
Like, even back then, you knew there was going to be something with him. Like he was going.
He wasn't expected to be the shoulders.
No. Nor was it shit in someone's bag. Curiously enough.
There you go. Yeah, give her the assist. There you go.
Okay. Here, have another one.
No, I'm not kissing it. Fucking
hell. I was just choking. Hey, back in the block.
I like it was a chicken bone.
Well, you need some alcohol. So I'm just saying now, right? If we do need backup in this feud, we know who to go turn to.
Not fucking Bubba, right?
No. Nope. But it's it, like, you know, it's the person they'd least suspect.
Undertaker?
Randy Orton.
Yeah, I don't think we get to pick, though, do we?
There is, if you do go with the tag team titles, you do get a choice of, like, who you want to tag. Like, there's people floating around the place, and, like, whoever's, like, ranked closest to you, you can go for. But I don't know, like, Orton could be, like, too, like, out of range for us.
Actually.
Do we have a glass? I have several glasses.
Notice how he actually looks like Public Enemy there.
Which one would you like?
In that outfit.
I'll go for Crash, thank you.
Notice how he looks like Public Enemy in that outfit.
A little bit, yeah. Curious enough.
Same type jersey, same type of outfit. And the hats as well.
Yeah. So. To be fair, like this, what I liked about these games was that the Create a Superstar ones, that there's like templates. And they're all wrestlers that were like around but didn't get put in the game.
Yeah.
So like number two I think is fucking Bull Buchanan. And I think one of them is Perry Saturn. Like there are people that are like in Just Bring It and they just didn't carry over to the next game. But the models are still the movesets and the character data is still there.
I used to remember like they had Jeff Hardy's stuff in there.
Yes.
But they just wouldn't use it. They retitled it Extreme number one.
That's right, yeah. They did the same with Angle for a long time, calling him Olympic.
Yeah. I remember one of the only good features about like these games back then was to create a superstar. Because they got better over time.
But also that though, and like unlike the 2K games where I think they've overcomplicated things a bit, these ones are so easy to make too. Like you could just pump out a granted, you didn't have much space to work with, but you could just make 20 custom wrestlers in a day. And then, because they were so straightforward, like, you didn't need to like put that much effort into it. Nowadays, you have to do, like, what is their septum like? Is it a wide septum? Is their cheekbones aligned? Is their face symmetrical?
Yeah,
like, I don't fucking care. Like,
Was it the 2K games that brought it in where you could upload your own picture?
Yes. Yeah, they did on the last few games,
fucking
yeah.
Creepy.
It's really weird. Especially when
The Sims started doing that as well.
Yeah.
And that was scary as
well. What, like your face?
You could literally upload your own picture so you could properly create yourself.
Oh, no.
They borrowed that from the 2K game, the basketball game.
You can actually upload, like, you can design your own tattoos as well, so you can add them to your sim rather than use the ones that they had in the game.
Yeah. I don't mind that. Like, things like that, like your tattoo.
But you're waiting, but like you're trying to get it, and then you're trying to get it like to be symmetrical.
Yeah.
And then you're actually trying to get the proper placement, and if you get one thing off, then everything is off.
It's
like
really noticeable.
Yeah, you look like the t-shirt Marge gets in The Simpsons, where her face is like off the side. That's what you end up your Sims looking at.
Yeah.
And you're like, oh, for fuck's sake. Ah. Been there like 12 hours, and then this is what happened. That's what you're left with.
Oh wow! So, I was actually just searching here for what was the actual create a wrestler templates. There's actually an FAQ here of like about 200 wrestlers you can recreate in Just Shut Your Mouth if you want to. It's great. I love that.
I also like the fact that they had wrestlers that they had everything related to different wrestlers, but it wasn't acknowledged.
Yes.
Oh, look at this roll up. Boom.
Oh, clever. I like that one. But here's the thing though, like as you said, like the but they gave you just the ingredients, and because like just for whatever reason didn't bring them in, just allowed you to do it anyway. That's good. I did like that.
Because you had the makings of the likes of a Tiger Mask or a Jushin Liger.
Yes.
But obviously, like
they couldn't
use it.
This is why I quite like these games, because they just realized, this is wrestling fans, and like there's no like, in a way, like bullshit politics around it. Like, now granted, they do, like in the new games, they do kind of do very on the sly. Like, there is a Destino there if you wanted it, but they've called it something else, so you'd like you'd have to really find it, you know. Or maybe you can make, in some of the other games, you could create a like a finisher, and you could have made a Destino if you wanted it.
So it's amazing that like you can...
What?
It's amazing that like if you give people the tools, they can be so goddamn creative.
Yeah, especially the professional, like, crate wrestler guys. They're fucking so talented.
Like, I mean...
You have immense people that, like, just create anyone and anywhere.
Yes!
Especially, like, the... Fire Pro?
Fire Pro, yeah.
Like, the amount of time that people put into those to create any wrestler.
They're unreal.
Like,
but they're so easy to make, though. Because I've done a few of the OTT roster in them.
But, like, even still,
they're
just
great,
like,
Paul Tracy.
I want to play.
It's a high entry level. I do have it on the PS4. It's a very high entry level, but once you get used to the whole, like, the kind of isometric layout and how it works, it does play okay. I still think it's a bit limited, I think. Well, a lot of people who, like, do actually quite like just, like, a wrestling arcade game will take it to water. I just think it's a bit light on content.
Seriously, Bubba, what the fuck, like...
What? Again, why are you beating up the heel, Eddie Guerrero?
No,
Bradshaw!
Oh, for fuck's sake!
Are we just, like... rinse and repeat, and I'm just a patsy for
what's
this?
What's going on here, lads? This is exactly the same thing.
Wait.
Oh, we don't know yet. Oh, well, okay. So far.
This is what happened last time.
Eddie, you hit him first.
No, Bradshaw's our backup.
Wait.
There we go. Fuck me. There's a lot more than that. All right.
Although, to be fair, I mean... this is a feud that they had anyways.
Yeah, that's true, actually, yeah. Ooh, and Jet Hardy Taker in the main event. That sounds very familiar, doesn't it? This seems like a good time to plug our Watch Grass With Me show. Go from the first episode all the way up, lads. It's very good. It's a good show.
We actually have the main event of this show. It was watched on that
one. Yes, indeed. Not too far away date-wise, either. I think it was in July. Yeah. Funny how that works.
Just watch What Graphs With Me.
Please.
All
please,
our original
you do need the views.
Idea.
You really do need the views.
All our idea.
Oh.
Maybe original.
Oh, boys, look. Maven's on Raw.
Hot Maven.
Hot. Yeah,
no, he's not.
He's a Maven. He's there. Against
Tajiri
and Mark Henry.
I didn't notice that, sorry. I see Tajiri versus Mark Henry, I see Eddie and Bradshaw, and I see Rikishi and Digger. It's like, where the hell is Maven?
By the way, we have really climbed down the match card here when you think about it. Like, we literally just went from, like...
We're on a street fight this time.
True, but, like, in terms of who we've been facing, we literally just went from, like, Steve Austin,
victory
against him.
We're up, and then...
Bubba Ray Dudley.
It was like, you didn't get the job done.
Yeah, apparently.
It's like...
Imagine
it was though in this type of situation. It's like when someone else starts playing the game and they're like playing as Bubba Ray, and then they're like, "Shit, I have to start taking in this prick Eddie Guerrero now because he's climbed up." I was like, "Is this what's happening?"
Oh, here we go.
I love how Austin is here as well.
Hi, I'm here.
Emotions are running wild here. Yep. Yes, they are.
Eddie has something to say. Ooh.
Battle Royal. I'd rather that than a Fatal 4-Way.
Good show. Good show. We can knock out Bubba, Bradshaw, Hardy, and then focus on Steve Austin.
Mm-hmm. Hopefully.
But what's it for? Is it for the hardcore title? Because Bradshaw's here.
It's for Pride.
Pride. Interesting. And that is a match set for Vengeance, which is our next pay-per-view.
Nice.
Got that for all SummerSlams in August.
When is SummerSlam?
Tomorrow. At time of recording, by the way.
Yeah.
When this comes out, it happened 2 weeks ago. Man, Randy Orton had a great match, didn't he? Just not in the green.
Oh, I can't believe.
I can't believe Drew McIntyre retained.
I can't believe Randy Orton
won the title.
We all knew that Dominic was definitely going to be going over Seth Rollins.
What a fucking match on Dominic, man. Wow.
I never saw it coming. Like,
how many flips did he do? 20? Oh, man.
Oh, my God. And he fucking stopped to, like, deliver a baby in the crowd as well.
Yeah, that was crazy. Which is impressive considering there was no one in the crowd. The Thunderdome, baby.
No, it was one of the wrestlers at the side.
Oh, was it? Yeah. That's gone, yeah. Was it just fucking like...
Delivered Seth Rollins as
just Reggie Scully. Just Reggie Scully just went... Ta-da!
I was trying to think who's actually...
That would be a hell of a feud.
I was actually trying to think who the fuck is even pregnant.
Could you imagine if that was the end to the Rollins-Mysterio feud? If it's like rights to Becky Lynch's child. Ladder match. Where the fuck is Becky?
Dominic, like, Mysterio doing a full circle. Eddie and Ray fought over me, so I'm gonna fight for you.
Oh,
edit that.
I guess you.
No, we're not editing that because Brian fucking.
Oh, God, I'm begging you.
Bruce Pritchard's gonna watch this and go, that's genius.
I'm begging you to take this out.
Shut the hell up!
Respect my authority.
Vaccines? What are you talking about, anyway?
Oh no, I think he's into vaccines. I just think he's into, like, killing his fan group. This is like, do you remember back in the 80s when, like, rock bands were being accused of killing off their fans with satanic, like,
lyrics
and stuff like that? Realistically, you probably could take Fonzie to court now for, like, well, you're endangering your fans by trying to kill them.
Oh, it's not even Fozzy. Was it Fozzy or was it his other
Fozzy
band he was doing?
Fozzy.
Quarantine,
okay. Fozzy gig.
Alright. Cool. Well, good to know. I mean, to be fair, if you do listen to Fozzy, then fucking have a word with yourself. They have two good songs, and that's it.
I like how me and Fozzy, like,
they have two good songs.
Like,
I'm sorry, we're not having this conversation. They are the most generic.
I saw Fozzy live.
Well, yeah, but
in Fibbers.
I've been to see him twice, so.
But that's for
you
it,
also
no,
at
be
that
honest.
Fibbers gig.
Be honest. Is that for Jericho or was it for the music?
I was at the Fibbers gig,
music.
Right, and I left that gig with two black eyes after being punched by two separate people. And, like, neither of them...
Oh, Tadgers.
Maven. No, I'm going for Maven. Fuck it, I'm going for Maven.
Okay, alright. I'm going to go for Tajiri.
You get Mark Henry.
I'll go Mark Henry.
Oh! Right, here we go.
That's like beyond belief, fact or fiction.
That's a lot.
Not this time.
Here we go.
So, right, I'm going for the psychic course.
Here we go.
Fuck off.
Oh!
Yeah!
More importantly, you lost. Tajiri was not mentioned in the decision.
He was not involved in the decision.
Yes. He was there being sneaky in Japanese.
Yeah, no, at that fucking gig.
Yeah, go on.
A fella, we were standing, we were like quite close enough to the front.
Yeah.
There was a fella standing in front of us and he was like getting a drink off somebody.
Mm-hmm.
And as he pulled back, he just elbowed back.
Oh, fuck.
And it hit me in the face.
So
and
it was actually
like,
unintentional.
So my head like rocked back. Yeah, so it was unintentional. Like, hit like. So it rocked me back a bit and I was like, Jesus Christ. And he's like, oh, I'm so sorry. I was like, no, you're fine, don't worry about it. And then I turned around and the person who I was with, like the group people are out of the gig, he got really excited for a particular song. And he went and did a fist pump in the air. And what did he do?
Another one. Fucking hell.
Right to the other eye. And then at that point, I just kind of went, fuck this shit. And then I moved to the back.
I thought you were going to say, like, fuck this shit and start swinging back at them.
No, and I moved so I was, like, closer to the stage. But like away from everyone else, and there was a fella who was like seemed to have the same idea, and he just looked at me and he went, "Are you okay?" Like, no, it really hurts.
I'm becoming.
That song wasn't even out
at
that
time.
I know. And it was just I think All That Remains was like literally I think was the song that would have been playing at the time.
Yeah.
And I was just like, yeah, my fucking eyesight is not one of them. Like at this point.
A
Went home.
Oh, I'm loving this concert.
Went home, and like the next morning I woke up and I was like, oh my god, why is my face so fucking sore? I was like, it felt as if like my sinuses were all blocked.
Mm.
Then I looked in the mirror and I went, oh,
that's
yeah,
why.
That's why. Now I had to go down. Downstairs.
Okay, this is a street fight, Foxy.
Yeah.
Let's make
I
it.
Press the wrong one.
No, that's okay. No, wrestling is very street fight. Nice. Slap that batch off. Oh, nice, nice, nice. He's dead already. Fuck me. You're a shit hardcore champion, Bradshaw.
He's playing possum.
He actually was
yes,
too.
He was.
He was. You know your Bradshaws.
I know my racist Texans.
Is he a racist Texan or is he just a prick? Can't remember.
I don't know. I think he's a bit of all.
He seems to play both sides. It's weird. Definitely Republican. That goes without saying. But I think like most wrestlers are Republican anyway, so kind of a bit redundant. Okay, here we go. Eddie's lining up the shot.
Oh!
Never mind. That was a very good like cheeky jab from Bradshaw.
Yeah.
You're not going to ask Redacted to do the other Redacted thing anymore, are you?
Which Redacted are you talking about?
The Redacted.
I don't know which one. I actually don't know what you're referring to.
Oh, sorry.
oh, no.
Let me just get the name. That Redacted.
Oh, no.
No?
No.
Just my note I like to say to the other person. That.
Gotcha.
Redacted with the Redacted. Oh, the Redacted. Holy
shit. Oh my god, it's the Redacted. Jeez, that'd be a good fucking...
Can that actually be a gimmick?
I was just about to say, can we just like have that as a stable now? The Redacted.
The Redacted.
Not obviously Redacted people,
yeah,
but like in kayfabe who are Redacted.
Yeah.